My name is Roxy Bukovets, and for the last month, I was working on a new module implementing Meilisearch API. So for today, I decided that I want to present to you what Meilisearch is, how I integrate it into Drupal 8 module, and to give you some information about the module, if you decide that you want to contribute to it. I could talk for hours about every single aspect of searching, Meilisearch itself, and how it is implemented into Drupal module. But I will try to cover what Meilisearch is as a service, what are the alternatives to Meilisearch. I will try to cover all of the features and give you some demonstrations of the Meilisearch. In the second part, I will go over modules architecture, installation and setup, creating a server and indexing, creating a search view and demo of searching. And I will give you some demonstration of other features. But what is Meilisearch? Meilisearch is an open source, ready-to-go search engine for everyone who wants a fast and relevant search experience for their end users. It is developed to work out of the box with little to no configuration, and not like Solr, which is configuration heavy and harder to use. Meilisearch is developers friendly because as soon as you download and launch the server, you get a test page with a search bar and statistics. But why Meilisearch? Yes, Meilisearch is not the first nor the only search engine there is, but it did find its place in the market. It's critical that you choose the right search engine based on what you need. So here I would like to go over other popular search engines. The first option you have is Elasticsearch. Elasticsearch can handle search through massive amounts of data and perform text analysis. In order to make it efficient for the end user, you need to spend time understanding more about how Elasticsearch works internally to be able to customize it and tailor it to fit your needs. Meilisearch is intended to deliver performant, instant search experience aimed at end users. However, processing complex queries and analyzing very large datasets is not possible. The second option you are probably more familiar with is Solr, but as soon as you probably remember, it is configuration heavy, and it's not that straightforward to set it up. Solr is a sub-project of Apache Lucene, created in 2004, and is today one of the most widely used search engines available. Solr is a search platform written in Java and built on top of Lucene. Furthermore, Solr is not only a search engine, it is often used as a document-structured NoSQL database. Documents are stored in collections, which can be compared to tables in a relational database. The last option is Algolia. Meilisearch and Algolia are basically quite similar products, with key differences. Meilisearch was inspired by Algolia's product and the algorithms behind it. Meilisearch is thus a new search engine based on the work of Algolia. It provides similar features and reaches the same level of relevancy just as quickly as its predecessor. But contrary to Algolia, Meilisearch is an open source project. So when developing Meilisearch module, I used Algolia's module for comparison. Meilisearch is equipped with a lot of functionality out of the box, but the main thing that is important to Meilisearch is that all of the options are optional. So if you want only the basic functionality, you get it out of the box with only running the server. I will go over every step of the process of how to set up Meilisearch, and how to create an index and how the search works. Modules architecture is divided into two parts. The first part consists of service, which serves as a wrapper of Meilisearch PHP library for the API calls to the Meilisearch server. And the second part is the Search API backend plugin, which extends the functionality of Search API and provides a backend on which you can attach indexes. Currently, the dev version of the module relies on a couple of dependencies. First is the Search API module, version 1.17.0, Meilisearch PHP library of 0.12.0, and Meilisearch instance of 0.12.0. For additional functionality, it uses Search API autocomplete and fastest module. Now I will go over the process of setting up Meilisearch and creating a new server and adding indexing and give you the demonstration of the functionalities. Here I'm running Drupal VM for my local environment, and I'm basically running Meilisearch inside that vagrant machine. As soon as I start the Meilisearch server, I get the welcome screen with some useful information. Here is the host address and the port number. This will be useful when creating a server on the Drupal site. First, we need to enable the Meilisearch Search API module. I have it already enabled. So for the next step, we must create a server. We should give it a meaningful name so we can remember what is the purpose of the server. And here is the important part. We insert the host address and the port number previously seen on the welcome page of the Meilisearch server. Good, now the server was created and we can verify that no indexes are saved on the server. The next step, we will attach a new index of posts that are saved into Drupal, so we can search for posts. We select content as a data source, and we select on which bundles we would like to be saved on the server. Now we can select the fields that we will perform searching on. So here I chose a title, category field, and body. Here we can see all content should be scheduled for reindexing. And all 8 posts that I have in my Drupal site will save it to the Meilisearch server. For displaying the results, I used Drupal View. Here we can give it a name and choose the index that you previously created. We additionally create a page and a menu link so that it would be easier for the users to find the search view. We should add all the fields that we need for the display of the results. And now the most important part is to enable full text search input field on that view and expose it as a filter so the user can enter their query and get the desired results. Now I need to just save the view and check if everything works. Sorry about that. Here you can see that empty query returns all of the results, but when the user enters the desired keyword, only the posts that contain at least one instance of that word are returned. Here you can see a few examples of the querying, and that's it. The very basic functionality of searching works. The next, and in my opinion, the most useful feature is autocomplete. For that, I used the Search API autocomplete module and extended it for the Meilisearch module. When we enable the Search API module, we get the additional tab in the index that says autocomplete. And here we can select the views that have Search API enabled on them. And that's it. We can check that the autocomplete works by going to the enabled view, and the spinner in the filter full text search field indicates that the autocomplete should return some results. The results are sorted based on the beginning of the word. If the query is the same as the results title, it should bubble it to the top. The next and quite useful feature is facets. For this I used already existing facets module and I extended it so it works with Meilisearch module. And here we can see that the facet source is already there, but this is basically a view that we created previously in the previous steps, and that view that has Search API enabled is basically a facet source. We can select a view, and on that view we can select the field that we would like to create a facet for. In this case, the category field is the obvious choice for the most optimal choice for the facet. and tweak a bit of settings so the results are rendered correctly. This created basically a new block that we can place whenever we want. I should place it in the sidebar first, as it's the most useful place for the facets, and we can check that this is working. These are basically the categories that these posts have, and if we click on some category, only the posts with that category field are rendered or returned from the Meilisearch server. The next big feature of Meilisearch is the capability of processing synonyms. Synonyms are basically the words that have the same meaning or very similar. The one example I found was quite useful. It can be used to render the correct results for the words that users most often type it wrong. So here I made a synonym for the word Drupal, and which basically means Drupal, but the user could type it wrong. So if I now search for Drupal, it gives me the Drupal results back. Previously, that wasn't possible. Sorry. The next big feature is the capability of selecting the stop words. Stop words are basically the words that have no meaning for the users. So this, that, was, will, or, and so on. So for the Meilisearch server, that means that if the user enters these words, it will automatically ignore them and provide faster and more relevant search results. Here you can see that I typed the word for, which is a stop word added to the server, and search contained no results. Also for the word in, and so on. Conclusion. That's basically it for the features. I think Meilisearch is blazing fast and provides super relevant search results. It is highly customizable and all of the extra options are all optional, so it's easy to set it up. Meilisearch just got funded, so we can expect a lot of improvements and new features. And some of the bad parts, Meilisearch isn't backwards compatible and it cannot perform data analysis, and a lot of features can still be improved. Thank you for listening and have a great day.